and lived an old man in the kingdom of Tess, who invented a purely original dress, and when it was perfectly made and complete, he opened the door and walked into the street by way of a hand, a loaf of brown bread, in the middle of which he inserted his head. His shirt was made up of no end of dead mice, the warmth of whose skins was quite fluffy and nice. His drawers were of rabbit skins, but it is not known. Waistcoat and trousers were made of pork chops. His buttons were Jujubes and chocolate drops. His coat was all pancakes with jam for a border, and a girdle of biscuits to keep it in order. Wore overalls screened from bad weather, a cloak of green cabbage leaves stitched all together. He had walked a short way when he heard a great noise, all sorts of beasticles, birdlings and boys, and from every long street and dark lane in the town, these birdles and boys in a tumult rushed down. 2 cows and a half in his cabbage leaf cloak, 4 apes seized his girdle which vanished like smoke. 3 kids ate up after his pancakey coat, and the tails were devoured by ancient egos. An army of dogs in a twinkling tore up his pork waistcoat and trousers to give to their puppies. And while they were growling and mumbling the chops, the boys pringed the Jujubes and chocolate drops. He tried to run back to his house, but in vain, for scores of fat pigs came again and again. They rushed out of stables and hovels and doors. They tore off his stockings, his shoes and his drawers. Now from the housetops with screechings descend striped, spotted, white, black and grey cats without end. They jumped on his shoulders and knocked up his hat. When crows, ducks and hens made a mincemeat of that, they greedily threw at his sleeves in tries, and utterly tore up his shirt of dead mice. They swallowed up the last of his shirt with a squall, whereupon he ran home with no clothes on at all. And he said to himself as he bolted the door, I will not wear a similar dress anymore, anymore, anymore.